Hello guys, in this video I will be telling you that how we can separate these pieces of UI into their own component. So one of the best things about React is we can create components to make a UI, and this helps in basically we can create a component once and we can reuse it anywhere we like. So in order to show you what I mean is, let me take you to a website. So this is Airbnb website. So as you can see, the whole layout of the website is basically divided into some components or maybe pieces of UI. So on the top here you can see there is a nav bar, and then there is a search box. So there is one component, there is second component, and then we have some categories, listings. So we have another component here. Here you can see we have some card component. We have cards of the rooms, we can say. But here you can notice there is a common pattern between the cards. So each of the card has some image, and then there is a profile like here, and there is a name of the maybe location, and then some price date also is there. So each of the card have similar layout. Here you can see all cards have similar similar size of image, similar text. That content is changing, but the layout is very similar. On the right side we have rating, and also here we have rating. So what is basically is they have created a component once, and they are reusing it multiple times by just changing the content in there. So let us see how we can use this React feature in our small app. So let me just take you there. Okay, so now what I want to do is basically separate these three pieces, so this one and this one, into their own components so that we can learn about React components. Okay, so first of all, let us say I want to separate this one. So let me create a new component, and how we can create a new component, please see carefully. So it starts with a function keyword. So component is similar to function, syntax basically. So we can create a, then we need to specify the name of component. So first function keyword and then name of component. So for example, navbar. And then curly brace, and then parenthesis, and then curly braces. Okay, so let me tell you something first. The name of component should always start with capital letter. This is a convention basically. Okay, so it is a good practice if you start your the name of your component with a capital letter, and rest is camel case. So whatever you return from this component will be rendered here. Let me show you how. Suppose I am returning, let us say, an h1 here, suppose like this. Let us say my navbar. Okay, so if you save, now nothing really happens because I have created this component, but I have not used this component. So let us use this component, and let me tell you how we can use it. We can use it just like native HTML elements. So for example, this is the name. If I want to use it, I can use angular bracket, then the name of component. So in this case, it is navbar, and it is a self-closing tag. Like this, we can use a component. So first of all, we have created this component, and right now here I am using this component. So what will actually happen is all of this HTML will be placed here conceptually. Okay, so this component will be rendered in this place. So let us see. Here you can see, so first this component is rendered, which is nothing but an h1. So here you can see h1 is rendered. Then second, this nav is rendered, this one, and so on and so forth. So here you can see we have abstracted the logic, we have abstracted the HTML or JSX into its own component. So here now I can use as many component as I want. So for example, I want to use it 3 times, suppose for some reason. I can just copy paste it, and there you can see I have created this component only once. I have created this component only once, and I can use it as many times as I want. So this is the power of React. Okay, so let us now delete this and do this more correctly. So what I'm gonna do is I'm extracting this nav, so cutting it and then placing it here. Okay, now I can use the above component like we have used before. So here you should see nothing change, because actually I have created the same layout but with the help of component now. So same HTML will be there, but the concept is different here. So let me save, and here you can see same thing. Let me extract out this piece also, so I can create a component like function, and let's call this main container. And we can return some JSX here. So let me cut this and paste here. And if I save now, you can see this is disappeared because I have created this component but I am not using it. So let us use it also. So as you start typing, this will give you a suggestion. Let us close this and save it. Here you can see our component is back basically. Now let me create another component for this footer. So function again, the name of the component, and then whatever we return from here will be rendered. So let me cut this one here and paste here, and now let us render it. Let us use it. So if I save now some problem is there. Actually, what the problem is, we were using name here but we do not have, because the name variable is inside this function, we are not having the name here. So we will see how we can solve this, but for now let me just comment it out so we can actually see some output. Let me save it, and this is back. So essentially what we have done is separated this piece and this piece into their own individual component. Now for some reason, suppose we can, the main advantage is basically we can reuse it. Suppose I want another main container, or maybe even in a different page. Okay, we can use it in a different page also, but for now let us do it in same page. So suppose I want to render main container again, so I can just copy this and just paste here. So now I have two similar looking components here. So this is the beauty of React, that I have written a component only once. I have written this HTML only once, and I am able to reuse it as many times as I want. Okay, so let us now solve the issue of these variables here. Okay, now one thing you might be thinking, like, there is a variable here. Now this is actually a function, and this also is actually a function. So somehow if we are able to pass this variable here, then our problems is solved, right? And we can actually do that. The syntax is bit different, but we can actually do it. Let me show you how. So suppose let us see the footer first. We require age variable here, so we can pass on this age variable like this. So age equal age, so just like HTML attributes. So this is the variable that will be available here, and this is the value we are passing. In order to avoid confusion, let me change the name here. Suppose I am changing it to my age. So now what we are doing basically is passing this variable, this age variable, by the name of this. Okay, so I can receive, just like we, you know, pass parameters in a function, we are doing similar things here. So I'm passing age as a my age, so I can receive my age in the footer. So let me receive it. So actually it is received in a props object, and in order to access age, you can do props dot age. Okay, so here age is not there, but as I save, we should see age. Not actually, yes, actually I'm not able to see it because we are using a different name. So it is actually my age, we are passing it as my age. So just a typing mistake here. Now we should see it, and here it is, the 21 is here. And if I, so basically what I am doing is passing this my age, and the value 21 is there. So the value is wrapped in a object. We can pass multiple, you know, multiple things. We can also pass name here like this. Okay, so we can pass this variable, and we can receive it all in props. So suppose if we want to now access the name here, so we can do props dot name. So let me save it, and here you can see the Rohan is there. So this is how we can pass data or variables into our components. There is an easier way to receive them. Instead of receiving in props, we can use ES6 destructuring. So what it looks like, let me show you, because it is very simple actually. You don't need to use props, you can directly get these values. So suppose I want to get my age, I can simply write my age, and I want name also, so I can use name. So now instead of using props dot my age and props dot name, we can simply use them like this. So it is much cleaner. You just have to use basically a curly braces here, and whatever prop you are passing, you can receive here, and you can render them as normal. Okay, so with time you will be get more comfortable in this, but this is how it works. Let me show you one more example so that it is clear. And as you can see, here are main container needs the name prop. Okay, so we can pass it. So suppose in this one I am passing, actually let me comment out this one first. Okay, so I can pass the name here like this. Okay, so now I can receive here. I can use props, but I'm using it directly, so we can use curly braces and name here. So this is essentially ES6 destructuring. If you know about this, then you will be able to understand it. Still, it is not very difficult. So here what I have done is pass the name here, and then receive the name here like this, and then simply rendering it as before. So let me save, and here you can see the Rohan is also appearing here. So this is very powerful thing, and here you can see the power. Suppose the name is changed, suppose the name is now Yash, and if I save it, so here you can see the name got updated in both the places. So this is very नो गुड थिंग अबाउट रियल. सो वी आर बेसिकली क्रिएटिंग अ डायनेमिक कंटेंट. वी आर नॉट हार्ड कोडिंग इट. वी आर यूजिंग द वेरिएबल्स एंड वॉट एवर द वैल्यू इन वेरिएबल विल बी गेट डिस्प्लेड. दिस इज हाउ द रिएक्ट, यू नो, दिस इज हाउ रिएक्ट कॉम्पोनेंट्स वर्क बेसिकली. सो नाउ लेट मी शो यू अनदर थिंग. अनदर थिंग, सपोज नाउ आई रेंडर दिस अगेन एंड आई वॉन्ट टू पास ऑन सम डिफरेंट नेम. ओके, सपोज आई वॉन्ट द नेम टू पास, बट आई वॉन्ट सम डिफरेंट नेम. लाइक आई वॉन्ट सम मे बी अभिषेक हेयर. सो वॉट इट विल डू इज, लेट मी शो यू फर्स्ट. सो हेयर यू कैन सी वी हैव टू मेन कंटेनर. द फर्स्ट वन हैज़ अ नेम ऑफ दिस वेरिएबल द यश एंड सेकेंड वन हैज़ अ नेम विच आई पास्ड इन हेयर. यू कैन ऑल्सो स्टोर दिस इन अ वेरिएबल एंड देन पास द वेरिएबल. आई हैव डायरेक्टली पास द स्ट्रिंग. नथिंग डिफरेंट एक्चुअली. वी कैन यू ऑल्सो स्टोर इट इन अ वेरिएबल. सो हेयर आई कैन, आई एम पासिंग द स्ट्रिंग हेयर एंड इट इज रेंडरिंग हेयर. सो द कॉम्पोनेंट इज सेम. बोथ द कॉम्पोनेंट्स आर सेम एंड द डेटा इज चेंजिंग. सो आई होप नाउ यू आर एबल टू रिलेट विद द एयर बी एन बी एग्जाम्पल. देयर द कार्ड्स आर देयर एंड दे हैव सिमिलर लेआउट, ओनली द डेटा इज चेंजिंग. सो वी कैन इम्प्लीमेंट थिंग्स लाइक दिस वेरी इजिली इन रिएक्ट. सो दिस इज वेरी गुड थिंग अबाउट रिएक्ट दैट आई लाइक. सो बेसिकली वॉट वी हैव लर्नड हेयर इज आई वॉन्ट यू टू प्रैक्टिस दिस ऑन योर ओन सो दैट यू गेट कम्फर्टेबल विद द सिंटेक्स. दिस इज सिंपली द नेम दैट वी वॉन्ट टू रिसीव देयर एंड वी कैन पास द वैल्यू इन हेयर. इट इज़ एज सिंपल एज दैट. वी कैन ऑल्सो यूज सम अदर वैल्यू हेयर लाइक दिस वन. एनीथिंग यू कैन डू. ओके, आई हैव शोड यू बोथ द वेरिएशन. वी कैन यूज, वी कैन पास अ वेरिएबल हेयर, वी कैन ऑल्सो पास अ स्ट्रिंग हेयर एंड वी कैन ऑल्सो पास अ नंबर. ओके, सो इन दिस एज सपोज यू वॉन्ट टू पास ऑन 31 एंड हेयर यू कैन सी द 31 इज देयर. सो दिस इज हाउ रिएक्ट कॉम्पोनेंट्स वर्क. सो एसेंशियली वॉट आई हैव डन इज सेपरेटेड दीज यू आई पीसीज इन टू देयर ओन इंडिविजुअल कॉम्पोनेंट्स एंड नाउ वी हैव ऑल्सो लर्नड अबाउट प्रॉप, पासिंग द प्रॉप्स. सो दीज आर नोन एज प्रॉप्स. ओके, सो आई होप दिस हेल्प यू लिटिल बिट. ओके, ग्रेट.